Hello everyone, I'm back here with line-to-line explanation, introduction, discussion of the title and analysis of the poem Childhood for class 11th. Childhood is written by the poet Marcus Natten. Marcus Natten, when he was 12 years old himself, wrote this lovely poem. And in this poem, he speaks about the loss of childhood. He regrets having lost that innocence that a child has. He's in fact curious to know when actually an individual stops being a child, when an individual ceases to be a child. And he wonders to himself whether it is the age in terms of years or the stage when the young mind learns to see through the hypocrisies of the adults and identifies his own distinctive character. So somehow I can say the poet deals with the theme of the loss of childhood, maybe because of the physical growth, because of the psychological growth, because of the development of thought, or it could be because of the influence of the worldly ways. However, the poet keeps on pondering about this question in almost all the four stanzas of the poem. Let us go ahead and start with the poem. When did my childhood go? Was it the day I ceased to be 11? Was it the time I realized that hell and heaven could not be found in geography and therefore could not be? Was that the day? Now, kindly notice, dear children, the poet uses interrogation in the beginning sentence of the stanza. He uses interrogation to convey a strong affirmation. And he wants to convey to the readers, to the listeners strongly that he has lost his childhood. And he's trying to find out the answer to his own question as to when he lost his childhood. He feels maybe it was the day he lost his childhood, maybe the day he ceased to be 11 and turned 12 years of age. So he wonders whether the loss of childhood is related to the number of years one has lived. Means when one turns 12 and ceases to be 11, stops being 11 years of age, was that the day that he lost his childhood? Or he feels it was perhaps that day when he discovered the theories of heaven and hell, and that geography did not provide him any information about the existence of such places. Actually, you know, according to a child's definition, geography is what? It is a study of places. He feels, the poet feels, that since there is no mention of heaven and hell in his geography textbook, so he rationally concludes that they do not exist anywhere. So what has happened is education has made the poet look at the world differently, with more reason and logic. He has developed a rationalistic approach, a scientific approach. The poet feels that he had probably lost his childhood when he had acquired a rational thinking towards his surroundings. So he feels maybe it was that day. Now the second stanza, when did my childhood go? Was it the time I realized that adults were not all they seemed to be? They talked of love and preached of love, but did not act so lovingly. Was that the day? Now in this stanza, he again, you know, he's pondering upon the same question as to when he lost his childhood. He wants to know about that. Now he feels whether he lost his childhood, he figures out, you know, that the adults around him did not practice what they usually preached. They taught others to be loving and caring when they themselves did not follow so. They were violent themselves. They were mean and selfish. So this is the time when the child lost his trust and faith in the adults. So the poet realizes that probably the loss of faith and trust might have been the major steps towards losing his childhood. In other words, we can say the child finds the adults to be double-faced. He observes that there's a wide gap between what they preach and what they practice. Hypocrisy, he feels, has taken the place of innocence in their life. And why does the child start feeling all this? Because the child is now heading towards worldly maturity. Was at the time I realized, in the second line, I here refers to the poet himself, because he is the one who represents the children whose childhood is leading way to adolescence. And which day is the poet talking about? He is talking about the day that announced the end of his childhood. So the hypocrisy of the adults is being talked about in this stanza. Third stanza, when did my childhood go? Was it when I found my mind was really mine? To use whichever way I choose, producing thoughts that were not those of other people, but my own and my alone. Was that the day? Now, in this stanza, again, he is asking and deliberating upon the very, very same question as to when he lost his childhood. Now, this line is very important. Was it when I found my mind was really mine, to use whichever way I choose? It means, when a child grows up and becomes a mature or becomes an adult person. So in this process of growing up, the child starts discovering that he is a distinctive personality. He has his own individuality and he finds himself to be unique. And he starts trusting his own, capability to reason, capability to think, capability to apply logic to things. So he found that his mind was really his. He was unique in his own way. He had his own mind which he could use whichever way he chose to. So he thinks that he has a distinctive character. He feels that his mind is powerful and it has the ability to take its own decisions. His own opinions and thoughts have earned him individuality. His own individuality, his own distinctive character in life. He has his own personality, which is unique and which is free from the biased notions or opinions of the other people. Because he feels, producing thoughts, let us see the fourth line, producing thoughts that were not those of other people, but my own and mine alone. He is very, very relieved, very proud and very confident of the fact that he is experiencing his own individuality in the process of growing up. Because he feels that he has a mind which can produce thoughts, which can take decisions, and those decisions, those thoughts are not dominated or controlled by other people now. When we are children, sometimes it is our parents who takes decisions on our behalf. Our thoughts are dominated and controlled by our parents. Sometimes it is the teachers, sometimes it is the other relatives. So one or the other person is always dominating or, controlling the perception or wisdom, or I would say the thoughts of a child during the stage of childhood. But as the child grows up, in that process of growing up, he learns rationalism. He starts having a rationalistic approach, a scientific approach. He starts feeling that he has a mind of his own and he can think on his own and can take his own decisions. And he's very proud of this fact. He says, I have a mind which can produce its own thoughts and it is just my own, my mind alone. And this is when he thinks that his individuality and experiences have taken away the childhood from him. Was that the day? Was that the day? He wonders. Now the fourth stanza and the last stanza of the poem. Where did my childhood go? It went to some forgotten place. That's hidden in an infant's face. That is all I know. Now finally, in the ending stanza of the poem, Childhood, the poet changes his question from when to where. You can see the change in the first line. Earlier, the repetition in all the three stanzas had been, when did my childhood go? And now he says, where did my childhood go? The answer is an easy one, you know. The poet wants to say that his childhood has gone. It has definitely gone. When? He doesn't know. But it has definitely gone, hiding into some forgotten place. And that forgotten place, that childhood, can be found in the face of an infant, he feels. Because an infant, a newborn child, a newborn baby, has the same kind of innocence that the children have during their childhood. So the last lines can be interpreted as that the childhood is a lost memory. We recall the fantasies, the make-believe world, the imaginary world that we create during our childhood period, and the moments associated with it. But at the same time, the innocence and the childhood are irrevocably lost. It can never be returned. It can never be, brought back. Once gone, it goes forever. So this is the poem, my dear children. I would like to discuss just few things with you, and one very important thing is the refrain in the poem, as I've already talked about it. Refrain is repetition of a single or more than one line which is repeated at, which comes at regular intervals throughout the poem. And the two lines which are the refrain of this poem, the two lines are, when did my childhood go? Was that the day? So this was the refrain. It's a very, very important literary device from this poem. And here I have in front of you the analysis of the poem. So the poet does wonder when and where he lost his childhood in this poem. And because he is curious to know the moment when he grew up, actually, when he lost his childhood, so he highlights, the poet highlights that when a child loses his childhood, he highlights that the innocence and faith are also lost. Because one starts gaining rational approach towards life, one starts gaining individuality of his own mind, of his own personality, of his own self. You know, dear children, adolescents, your stage right now, it is a very confusing time, for all of you. You sometimes feel you are treated as children, and at the other times you are treated as being grown up, though not completely adults. But definitely, it is a confusing period because a child does not easily accept the physical, the hormonal, the psychological changes in his or her personality. He feels no longer like a child and cannot himself call an adult either. So what he feels? He starts believing that he has lost the innocence and purity of his childhood to some unknown and unforgettable place. So the poem, through his the poet, through this poem, wants to confront the readers with the fact, with the question as to when and where have we all lost our childhood. And the answer is, it leads to self-discovery. We have to discover ourselves as to when we as individuals lost our childhood behind. The poet somehow feels disappointed, he regrets, he has a remorse, he bemoans the loss of childhood. He regrets having lost his childhood. Somewhere we can feel that he seems to have a desire of living his childhood once more. Because a child's life is always peaceful and very sweet, while an adult's character is very complicated. The child always lives in a make-believe world of his own, an imaginary world of his own. He feels that every story has a happy ending. And when he develops a rational approach towards life, his perception of the world changes completely. And this is what we need to ponder on. We need to have a deep insight of. We need to understand. I guess I have given enough to have a clear understanding of the poem. So thank you, and stay safe, stay positive.